Yes guys, so question number 32. Now we have a subsidiary and an investment in a joint venture as well as an associate. Air Limited, a listed company, entered into an expansion program on 1st April 2011 and on that date, the company purchased from Bag Limited its investment in two private limited companies. The purchase was of entire share capital and 50% of the share capital of Dry. Both the investments were and after acquisition, Air Limited, after acquisition by Air Limited, Dry Limited will be run by Air Limited and Bag Limited as a jointly controlled entity. That means basically this company Dry Limited will become a joint venture of both Air Limited as well as Bag Limited, 50-50 holding. Air Limited makes its financial statements on 31st March every year and the terms of acquisition of Cold and Dry are as follows. Cold is buying the entire share capital, so it becomes a 100% subsidiary without any minority interest. But in the case of Dry Limited, it becomes a joint venture with 50% venture or share in the joint venture. Cold Limited, the total consideration was based on the PE of 12 multiplied by its reported profits of 20 lakhs of Cold Limited and for the year 31st March 2011. The consideration will be settled by Air Limited by issuing 8% debentures for 140 lakhs at par, balanced by new shares of 1 rupee each based on the market value of 2.5 each. So there is some securities premium of 1.5 rupees per share. How many number of shares we do not know, we have to calculate that. For Dry Limited, the market value of Dry Limited as on 1st April 2011, that is the date of acquisition, was 375. But he is acquiring only 50%. So 50% of 375 is 187.5. That is the PC. And how is he paying this? It is satisfied. Air Limited has satisfied its share of 50% of this amount by issuing 75 lakh 1 rupee equity share at a market value of 2.5 each. 75 lakh shares, each one 2.5 worth, 187.5 again. Air Limited has not recorded in its books the acquisition for the above investments or the discharge of the consideration. Check in Air Limited balance sheet, there is no investments which are acquired. So he did not record the entry for the investments. So acquisition of investments and discharge of PC, these two entries we have to post as far as Air Limited is concerned. The summarized balance sheet of the financial position as on 31st March 2012 is as under. So three companies, Air Limited which is a holding company, Coal Limited is a subsidiary and Dry Limited is a joint venture with 50% share. The book value of the net assets of Cold and Dry on the date of acquisition are considered to be a reasonable approximate of their fair values. So since they are considered as reasonable approximate of fair values, no revaluation is necessary. The current profits of Dry and Cold for the year ended 31st March 2012 were 80 lakhs and 20 lakhs respectively. No dividend was paid by any company during the year. Guys, instead of giving you what was the profit at the time of acquisition, he is giving you current year profits. Once I know current year profits, I can definitely identify what is the amount of profit which is existing on 1/4/2011, that is the date of acquisition. Dry Limited, the jointly controlled enterprise, is to be accounted as per AS 27 and the goodwill in acquisition of Dry Limited is impaired by 10 lakhs on 31st March 2012. Impaired is nothing but reduction. Impairment is is a loss in the value of goodwill. So the loss is 10 lakhs. So I need to reduce the goodwill by 10 lakhs. So I am reducing the asset side by 10 lakhs. There should be something which is reduced even on the liability side by 10. That will be your reserves for CBS. So the goodwill adjustment should be with the reserves for CBS to the extent of 10 lakhs. And the gain on acquisition, if any, will be separately accounted. Prepare a consolidated balance sheet of Air Limited and its subsidiary Cold and its joint venture Dry. So let's start guys with the date of acquisition. Date of acquisition is 1st April 2011. Both the investments were acquired on the same day. That was the day when he has actually entered into an expansion program to purchase the shares from Bag Limited. Now he is buying from Bag Limited check your shareholding pattern now. If you observe the shareholding pattern, he already purchased 100% in Coal Limited. So all the shares are held by Air Limited itself. Number of shares and percentage holdings. First company is Coal. Only Air Limited holds 100% holding he acquired. The number of shares that he has purchased from Coal is 20,000, because the share capital is 1 rupee share. The total share capital is 20,000. So 20,000 shares. Come to dry, the share capital is 25,000 shares, but he has acquired only 50% of it. In Dry Limited, I'll only write Air Limited share. This is only Venture or share. Venture or share in joint venture. He purchased 50%, 12,500 shares. Now, if you observe, there is no adjustment as far as the profits are concerned. I can directly go for your distribution table. So, let's start the distributions. Guys, first let's calculate the PCs first. He has given some details. Let's get the PC, then we'll go for the distribution table. Purchase consideration. First, for Coal Limited, read the para, you will get the PC. The total consideration in Coal Limited was based on a price earning ratio of 12 applied on its reported profits of 20. So basically 12 into 20 is 240. That is the PC. The consideration was settled by Air Limited by issuing 8% debentures for 140 lakhs at par. So out of 240, 140 is settled by way of 8% debentures. The balance 100 will be settled in the form of 1 rupee equity share, each one issued at 2.5. So let's check. Purchase consideration is equal to price earnings into earnings, 20 lakhs into 12, total becomes 240. How is it discharging the PC? Discharge of PC. First one, PC in 8% debentures. He is issuing 8% debentures to the extent of 100. My total PC is 240. That means my PC in equity shares. 140. My PC in equity shares of Air Limited is 100. If each share is issued at 2.5, then calculate the number of shares. Forty shares of rupees 2.5. It is a 1 rupee share. It is issued at 2.5. It includes 1.5 rupees of a premium in this. If I have to record this entry, We'll record it like this. Investment in cold account debit, 240 to 8% debentures. I'm issuing them debentures to the extent of 140 to equity share capital. I will not write 100 because each share is only is 1.5 rupees of a premium, so there should be a securities premium which should come into picture. Forty rupees share capital, 1 rupee, 1.5 premium, 60. Share is issued at 2.5, 1 rupee share capital, 1.5 rupees is premium. That is a PC of cold. Now get the PC of dry. This he directly gave. Purchase consideration is 50% of check. The market value of Dry Limited is mutually agreed at 375. 187.5. How is he discharging the PC? He is discharging by way of 75 lakh shares, each one issued at 2.5. Discharge of PC, entire thing is PC in equity shares, of Air Limited, 187.5, this is nothing but 75 lakh shares issued at 2.5 each. Now if I have to record an entry for this, we'll record it like this. Investment in Dry Limited account debit, 187.5 to equity share capital, ₹75 lakh share, ₹75 share capital. Securities premium, 1.5 rupee premium on 75 lakh shares is 112.5. 75 lakh shares into 1.5 premium. We got PC of both companies, then we can go for distribution. You can start with either. This is not a chain holding problem. So I'm starting with Coal Limited, 100% subsidiary. Check. How many reserves are there? There's only one reserve, that is a retained earnings there. So only a retained earnings in Coal Limited, the value of the retained earnings is 15,000. Everything is given in thousands for us. Oh, I'm really sorry guys. I think we have recorded the entries in lakhs. Yeah, we have recorded the entries in lakhs. When we are writing it down, please make sure that you are adding two zeros because the balance sheet is in thousands. Balance sheet is in thousands. Try to add two zeros when you are recording the entries. Yep. Now, the retained earnings is 15,000. But the current year profits were 80 lakhs and 20 lakhs for cold and dry. So for cold, it is 80 lakhs. 80 lakhs in thousands is nothing but 8,000. If 15,000 is the closing figure, 8,000 is the current year profit, then the opening profit was 7,000. So, let's split it in pre-acquisition and post-acquisition columns. retained earnings, my current year profit is 8,000, 80 lakhs. Total is 15,000. So pre-acquisition should be 7,000. There's no distribution because Co Limited is entirely held by heir. 100% holding. So heir limited share will be same. Then let's come to dry. Air limited share is 50% of this. Only one reserve again. Retained earnings. Check. Dry limited's retained earnings are 4,500 as on the balance sheet date. Current year profits are 20 lakhs or 2,000. Current year is post acquisition 2000. Then obviously my opening should be 2500. Air limited share is 50% of this. So 1250 and 1000. We have distributions now. When go for cost of control. Identify goodwills. Air and cold, air limited and dry. One is a subsidiary, one is a joint venture. There is no dividend adjustment, directly start with cost of investments. We have just calculated in PC. Co Limited PC is 240. Dry Limited PC is 187.5. So compare this with share in net assets. Given by share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. Once again guys, I need to write it in thousands. It's given in lakhs. Add two zeros. This will be 24,000 and 18,750. Writing in thousands. Come on, share capital. Air and cold, 20,000. Air and dry, 12,500. Pre-acquisition reserves in cold is 7,000, in dry is 1,250. 7,000, 1,250. This is 27, leaving you a capital reserve of 3,000. This is 13,750, leaving us with a goodwill of 5,000. First case, I have a capital reserve, 3,000. And second case, I arrive at a goodwill of 5,000. But there's a small adjustment here. Read the point number C. Point number D. The goodwill in respect of acquisition of Dry Limited was impaired by 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs is nothing but 1000 thousands on 31st March. So this is impaired by 1000 less impairment is nothing but loss in the value of goodwill. 1000. This will give you a balance of 4,000. Combined goodwill and capital reserve, because both are consolidation standards, My resultant goodwill will be 1000. Guys, but you don't have to combine because the last sentence of the point number D, gain on acquisition, if any, will be separately accounted. So leave this capital reserve separately, leave this goodwill separately as far as the balance sheet is concerned. But normally we can report it this way. But as far as the problem is concerned, since he clearly specified that, take capital reserve of 3000 and goodwill of 4000. Do I need minority interest now? Joint venture, I don't need to calculate minority interest. Subsidiary also, I don't have to calculate now because it is a 100% subsidiary. So there is no minority in your company. So go for your reserves for CBS. Only one reserve, that is the retained earnings. Always start with the holding company shares, that is Air Limited balance. Air Limited's balance in retained earnings is 20,800. Subsequently, we need to add Air Limited share in post acquisition reserves of two companies, cold and dry. Post acquisition reserves are 8,000 and 1,000. One last adjustment, impairment of goodwill. Goodwill was reduced. Here I have to reduce even in your reserves. We'll see it as a separate standard, guys. AS 28, impairment. Reserves to be reported in consolidated balance sheet is 28,800. If you are clear till here, then you can go for the balance sheet, but be very careful when you are drafting the balance sheet because the acquisition entries were not passed. These two entries, this is the first entry for the acquisition in coal. Similarly, I have an acquisition entry as far as dry is concerned. These two entries were not passed. We need to pass the entries now. So incorporate the entries and draft the balance sheet. Yes, guys, let's see the consolidated balance sheet. CBS of Air Limited. As on 31st March 2012, start with equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds. Share capital. Go on, guys. Check your equity share capital. Share capital, what is already given in the balance sheet is 10,000 plus the share capital which we got here is 4,000. 40 lakhs is 4,000 plus 7,500. So 7,500 plus 40 is 1150. 1150 plus 10,000. So what is the total? 21,500. Come for your reserves and surplus. First reserve, I'll take as securities premium. Securities premium because we have a premium on issue of shares. 60 plus 112.5 is 172.5. Capital reserve next. In your cost of control, we have a capital reserve. One second, guys. 172.5 is in lakhs. So we have to write it as 17250. 17250. Then capital reserve of 3000. Finally, my retained earnings. We already solved for the consolidated retained earning. 28,800. There is no minority interest should be to be presented there. But I have a non-current liability. We have just issued debentures. Non-current liabilities. 8% debentures issued to discharge the PC of coal. 140. So I have to write, add two zeros, it will become 14,000. Next, remaining three things I have current assets, sorry, current liabilities, and place them directly. Current liabilities, first one, trade payables is nothing but the creditors, overdraft, provision for taxes. Trade payables or creditors. Overdraft, that is a bank overdraft. And finally, provision for tax. When we are consolidating, guys, Air Limited being the holding, Cold is a subsidiary, Dry is a joint venture. So for the Cold, we have to do full consolidation, add the total net asset. But for Dry, we need to do proportionate consolidation. Proportionately, we are supposed to add the trade payables are 17,120 plus 5720 plus 50% of 14,100. That is nothing but 7050. Overdraft, only one figure, 1540. Provision for tax, 5640 plus 2400 plus 50% of 760. 50% of 760 is 380. 8,420. Balance sheet on the liability side, that is assets, non-current assets,
First one is tangible fixed assets.
Check the tangible fixed asset, 34,260 plus 27,000 plus 50% of 21060. 51% of 21060 is 71,790. Then I have an intangible asset. Intangible asset is nothing but the goodwill part. After impairment, goodwill is 4,000. Three current assets we have. Take one by one. First current asset, inventory, debtors and cash. Check inventories. Inventory 9640 plus 7200 plus 50% of 18640, 50% is 9320. You added 26160. Debtors 11200 plus 5040 plus 50% of 4620, 50% of 4620 is 2310. Much 18,570. Finally, with the cash 3410 plus 40, 50% of 40 is 3430. End of the balance sheet, guys. Nine lakh twenty-three thousand nine fifty is the balance sheet total. We have consolidated with 100% subsidiary and a 50% joint venture. With that, we come to the end of 32 problem. Under the problem number 33, now I have a subsidiary, joint venture and an associate, everything combined. P Limited owns 80% of subsidiary S, 40% of joint venture J and 40% of an associate A. J is a jointly controlled entity and A is an associate. Summarized balance sheet of four companies are given to you, holding, subsidiary, joint venture, associate. Associate, I won't do line by line addition. Joint venture, I'll do proportionate consolidation, and subsidiary, I'll do full consolidation. P Limited acquired the shares of S Limited many years ago when S Limited's retained earnings were 520 lakhs. However, the retained earnings today could be something different. You can get pre-acquisition and post-acquisition from that. There's only one reserve existing in the balance sheet, that is your retained earnings. P Limited acquired its shares in J Limited at the beginning of the year when J Limited's retained earnings were 400. P Limited acquired the shares of A Limited on 1/4/2011 when A Limited's retained earnings were 400.
The balance of goodwill related to S Limited was written off 3 years ago, and the value of goodwill in joint venture remains unchanged. He did not talk about value of goodwill in associate because it will never come into the balance sheet at all. It is an associate. Associate goodwill will not come into the balance sheet. Prepare to consolidate the balance sheet as per case 21, 23 and 27. Then we are clearly giving the differentiation as joint venture and associate.
Yes guys, so we were talking about problem number 33. So the subsidiary, joint venture and associate, we have three companies there. For P Limited, which is being a holding company, P owns 80% of subsidiary, 20% owned by minority interest, and he owns 40% of joint venture. I am not concerned about the remaining 60, associate of 40%. P Limited, if you observe, the dates of acquisition for S Limited is just set as many years ago. He did not specify exact date of acquisition for subsidiary. But however, we don't need it because S Limited's retained earnings were 520 lakhs and P Limited acquired the shares of J Limited, that is the joint venture, at the beginning of the year. The current financial year ending on 31st March 2012. That means my beginning of the year date of acquisition should be 1/4/2011. So as on that date, retained earnings of J are 400. And for an associate, he clearly gave you the date of acquisition as 1/4/2011 when the retained earnings are 400. The balance of the goodwill relating to S Limited was fully written off 3 years ago. So we need to reduce it in your cost of control and also in your reserves for CBS. It's an impairment of goodwill. Then the value of goodwill in J Limited is unchanged. A Limited's goodwill will never appear in the balance sheet. So I'm least bothered about that. So he's asking you to prepare the balance sheet of P Limited as on 31st March 2012, as per 21 for the subsidiary, 23 for the associate, 27 for the joint venture. Start with your dates of acquisitions. Date of acquisition. P Limited in subsidiary S. P Limited in joint venture J. P Limited in associate A. This not available data, but this is 1/4/2011, beginning of the current financial year. This is also 1/4/2011 given to us. Let's go for the shareholding pattern then. Number of shares and percentage holding. Number of shares first in the subsidiary S. Limited and minority, because P Limited acquires only 80% holding, balance 20% in the hands of minority interest, my total holding of 100%. Check the shares. Each share is 1 rupee. In subsidiary, total shares are 400. This total is 400. 80% is 320. 20% is 80. Then go for the analysis. Analysis of reserves. I don't need the analysis, I guess, because we directly have the amounts. One second, guys. First, let's complete for J also. In joint venture, write only P Limited share, 40%. Similarly, in associate also, write only P Limited share, 40%. Can you fill up the number of shares? 1 rupee share, 800 and 800 both. 800 into 40% is 320. For both, I'll get the same answer, 320. I don't need analysis. I'll directly go for the distribution table. Distribution of reserves. Only run reserve existing, that is retained earnings there. So split it between pre-acquisition and post-acquisition. And start. First, I'll start it with S Limited, the subsidiary. Check. S Limited, P acquired in S Limited many years ago when S Limited's retained earnings were 520. When he acquired it was 520, so 520 is pre-acquisition. Balance sheet date, the value is given as 3400. So 3400 minus 520 is 2880. Split this between P Limited for 80% and minority for 20%. Is 416 and 104. Is 576 and 2304. Subsidiary is over. Go for the joint venture, J Limited. Again, check your retained earnings. Of that, again get only your P Limited share, 40%. Check. When he acquired in the joint venture J at the beginning of the year, J Limited's retained earnings were 400. But on the balance sheet date, J Limited's retained earnings is 3600. So 400 existing on the date of acquisition, pre-acquisition. The balance 3200, that is the difference between the balance sheet date balance and the opening balance of 400 is post. 40% of that is 160 and 1280. Similarly for A Limited. Retained earnings. J Limited, P Limited acquired in A Limited on 1/4/2011 when A Limited's retained earnings were 400. Again, balance sheet balance is 3600. Same distributions like J Limited, 400 and 3200. Again, identify only P Limited share from this, 40%, 160 and 1280. information sufficient to go for your cost of control. Maintain three columns for cost of control. P in S, P in J, P in A. I will start with cost of investments. Check your balance sheet asset side, fill up the values. There is no dividend adjustment again. Asset side investments 800, 600, 600. Compare this with share in net assets. Split between share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. Share capital. Check. Every share is 1 rupee each. So P in S 320, P in J 320, P in A 320. Pre-acquisition reserves 416, 160. My total share in net asset is 736, 480 and 480. Throughout I have a goodwill. First case it is 64, next two is 120 each. Check. Read the line exactly. Two lines, last two lines, the balance of goodwill relating to S has been written off 3 years ago. So this 64, which is relating to the subsidiary, has been written off. You can call it as impairment or write off. Goodwill written off 64. This goodwill is zero. This 120 will never come to the balance sheet. So what will appear in the balance sheet is only this 120 relating to joint venture. We need to calculate minority interest as well. We have 20% minority in the subsidiary S. Their share in net assets represented by share capital and reserves. Minority share in the share capital, minority share in the reserves. Reserves we have split between pre-acquisition reserves and post-acquisition reserves. Their share in the share capital, check your shareholding pattern, 80. Their share in the reserves, check your distribution table, 104. And 576, total is 760. Then finally your reserves for CBS. Your carrying cost of investment also we have to do. I'll do that. Retained earnings, let's complete first this one. We'll go to the carrying cost of investment. We have one more working note for the associate to be prepared. Yep, this is for CBS. First one, start with the holding company share, P Limited. P Limited's balance or shares, P Limited balance in the balance sheet for the amount of retained earnings. Is 4,000. Add his share in post acquisition reserves.
share in post acquisition reserves. Of joint of subsidiary S, joint venture J, associate A. Values are 2304, 1280, 1280. Finally, goodwill written off. This is 8800. For the associate, we need to calculate carrying cost of investments. Carrying cost of investments in associate A. First, to get cost of investment, we'll start using the reverse of cost of control. So we'll start with share in net assets. Represented by share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. Check his share in share capital is 320. His pre-acquisition reserve is 160. My share in net assets is 480. Plus goodwill 120. This will give me cost of investment in A. 600. To this we add share in post acquisition reserves of A, what we have already added in reserves for CB is 1280. The same 1280 I'll add even here, and that will give me carrying cost. There should be one more addition normally, that is amount of post acquisition dividend receivable from A. There is no post acquisition dividend receivable. Carrying cost of investment in A is 1880. Sufficient enough working notes to prepare your balance sheet, guys. Go for the balance sheet.
Yes, guys, let's complete the balance sheet. Consolidated balance sheet of P Limited. As on 31st March 2012, equity and liabilities shareholder funds. Under shareholder funds we have share capital. Check the share capital of P. P Limited share capital is 1000. Then comes my reserves and surplus. What is the reserve that you have here? There's no capital reserve that I have, but I have only a retained earnings. We already have the figure of 8,800. Minority. $760. No non-current liabilities, directly current liabilities. Creditors, that is the only current liability. P Limited's credit are 200 plus full consolidation with subsidiary plus 300. Proportionate consolidation with joint venture 40% of 250. Associate no consolidation, we do only equity method. So the total is 600. Come to the asset side. How many assets are there? The three assets, fixed assets, current assets, and there's also goodwill. Assets. Non-current assets. Tangible fixed assets. Go with the same thing. Full consolidation with subsidiary and proportionate consolidation with joint venture. Fixed assets are 1000. Full consolidation with subsidiary 800 plus proportionate 40% of 140 is 560. Add total 2360. Intangible asset, goodwill. Value of goodwill, only the joint venture goodwill should be considered, 120. Other non-current assets, investments. Investment in associate, this should appear. We already calculated 1880. Finally, your current assets. $2,200 holding company. Full consolidation with subsidiary. $3,300. That is $5,500. Plus proportionate consolidation as far as this joint venture is concerned. 3250 into 40%. That is nothing but $1,300 plus $5,500 is $6,800. 11,160. Balance sheet total is 11,160, and there the balance sheet tallies. Even this problem we did not have adjustments, guys. For the next one, that is the 34th problem, we'll have some adjustments within the same associates as well as joint ventures.